Welcome to Toddledom Children. Your Cecilia teacher is back with an interesting topic today. Are you all ready? Yes, you all wanted to know what is that interesting topic? Yes, come on, close your eyes all of you. Yes, yes, rub your palm. Close, keep it on your eyes. Yes. Abracadabra, gili gili, choo! Yes, it's a story time. Are you all ready to listen a story? You like to listen story, children? Yes, your mama tells you story, your daddy tells you story, isn't it? Today, teacher is going to tell you story. Okay, are you all ready? Now, you all are bored at home, isn't it? Not able to go outside in the garden, in the park. Yes, so today we'll enjoy listening the story. Okay, children, are you all ready? Come on, here we go. Rose and the Red Shoes. Once upon a time, there was a cobbler whose name was Peter. He used to make beautiful shoes. He had a beautiful daughter whose name was Rose. Once Peter fell very ill. The doctor advised him to take complete rest for at least 6 months. So it was very difficult for Peter to work and fulfill his day-to-day needs. Rose used to take good care of her father, lovely. Rose was fond of wearing different types of shoes. But now due to her father's illness, she had no shoes to wear. She used to walk bare feet everywhere. Oh no, so sad. One day, she was coming back home from the market. She saw a rich girl throwing a pair of beautiful red shoes. Rose was very happy to see those shoes. She just grabbed them and came home running to her father. Her father said, "Throw away these shoes immediately. You should never pick up anything off the road." But Rose was a stubborn girl. She simply refused. Rose hid those shoes outside the house and started wearing them every day. After a few days, her father passed away due to illness. Rose was very sad. Now she all alone. She wore her red shoes and started wandering on the streets everywhere, every day. An old woman used to watch Rose from her window. She was a kind lady, but she had no children of her own. When she learned that Rose was all alone, she decided to adopt Rose, but she requested Rose to throw away her red shoes, and she did not like them. Rose was very disappointed, but she thought, at least she will have a roof over her head and good food to eat. So she agreed. The old woman treated Rose very well. Rose had her own room, a bed to sleep, new clothes to wear, and she even got a new pair of shoes. Very nice. Now, Rose started going to school and even made some new friends. She used to study very hard. Rose was happy, but sometimes she still missed her red shoes. Years passed. Now Rose grew up into a beautiful young girl. One day, the old lady took Rose for shopping. Yes, you all understood the story. What was it about? There was a girl whose name is Rose. Yes, she lost her dad. Yes, her dad was sick and passed away.
Now she was all alone. She was very sad. She cried. Now who will look after me? Who will look after me? She was very sad. She was thinking of that and she walked away. There she saw an old lady. The old lady called her and said, "Rose, can you please come here, beta?" Then she came. Then she said, "I am ready to adopt you. Can you please come to my house? I will take care of you. I will give you good food. Please come." The Rose also agreed. She said, "Okay, now I am all alone. I got a grandmother to look after me." And then one day what happened? Grandmother and this Rose, where they both went? Yes, they both are going to the market, isn't it? They both are going to the market. Yes, children. Now, let's see what and all they buy in the market. Okay? Yes.
She bought her new dresses, books, bags and a lot of other things. Finally, they went in a shoe shop. As they entered the shop, Rose saw a pair of beautiful red shoes. She said they are exactly like the shoes she had when she was small. But the red shoes were expensive. The old lady said, "Rose, you can buy 2 pair of shoes in the cost of this one. And the red shoes are very shiny. You cannot wear them everywhere." But Rose was simply being stubborn. "I don't want to wear any other shoes. I want this red shoes." Finally, the old lady had to buy those red shoes for Rose. Now, Rose was very happy. Yay! On the way back home, she was dancing, singing and laughing with joy. Yay! Every day, Rose wore her red shoes to school. Her friends and teachers started gossiping about her shiny shoes. But Rose just did not care. The principal called her and asked her not to wear such a shiny and fancy shoes in school. Rose arrogantly answered back, "My feet, my shoes," and just walked away. An old teacher walking by heard everything. She called Rose and said, "Wow, such lovely pair of shoes." Rose was overjoyed and the old teacher appreciated her shoes. Then she bent down and whispered something to shoes. Suddenly, the shoes started dancing. They danced and danced. "Oh, what is happening to me? Why can't I stop dancing?" Her friends were watching everything. They said, "Rose, what are you doing? Stop dancing immediately. This is school. You can't just dance around like a crazy person." Rose said, "Believe me, I want to stop dancing, but I can't. Something is wrong with my shoes." Now the shoes started taking her away from the school. So sad. The shoes were not ready to stop. They took Rose on the street to the market. Everyone was looking at the dancing girl and making fun of her. Ha 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 ha. Rose started praying. She was really tired. Her feet hurt. But somehow she managed to reach school. She requested the old teacher to help her. She told her that she had realized her mistake and she will never be arrogant. The old teacher took pity on her. She again bent down and said something to the shoes. And finally, the shoes stopped dancing. Rose thanked her and went home. Now she had learned her lesson. She said to the old lady, "I am sorry for all the trouble I have given you." The old lady was happy. They lived together happily. Wow, such a wonderful story.
Did you all enjoy the story, children? Yes. You all loved the story? Yes. Come on, show me your smiley face, all of you. Show me your happy face. How we make a happy face, smiley face? Come on, keep like this. Smile and show. Yes. You all enjoyed? Yes, come on, clap for yourself now. Yes. What you all learned from this story, children? What did you understood from this story? Huh? Yes, you should always respect our elders. We should always obey our elders. Whatever our parents says, whatever our elders says, you should always listen to them and be a good children. Not to be a stubborn, not to be adamant. No, I say you should not say, okay? You should listen to them. Only then you can be a good children. Okay? Till then, bye-bye for today's session. We have come to end of this session. Okay, children? We'll see you soon with the next interesting topic. Okay? Bye.